हेलो एवरीबॉडी, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी आवर नेक्स्ट पॉइंट दैट इज अरिथमेटिक मीन. ओके, मीन्स नाउ वी हैव स्टार्टेड आइडियल मेजर्स ऑफ सेंट्रल टेंडेंसी. ओके, सो फ्रॉम दैट फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज अरिथमेटिक मीन. ओके, अरिथमेटिक मीन फॉर अनग्रुप्ड डेटा. Okay, so that in short we can say AM. So for that mean, how to find out mean? Mean means sum of all observations divided by number of observations. Okay, so same formula we are going to use. So arithmetic mean is equal to, we can write arithmetic mean, for that we write bar x is equal to x1 plus x2 plus x3, okay, till that xn divided by n. N means number of terms or number of observations. Okay, so this we can write in short, that is summation of, this is the sign of summation of xi means this summation of this all. Okay, from n, okay, n to, means it is the last observations and this is the first, so that we can write I is equal to 1. Okay, first to last, and here we need to divide by number of observations, so 1 by n. Okay, so this is the this is the formula to find out mean, arithmetic mean. Okay, in short we can keep in mind number of observations divided by sum of all observations divided by number of observations. Okay, so one example we will see here, that is find the mean of all factors of 12. So first we must know the factors of 12. Factors of 12, we can write 1 is the factor of 12, 2, 3, 4, okay, 4 3 is 12, 6 2 is, and last factor is 12. Okay, so here arithmetic mean is equal to sum of xi divided by number of observations. So sum of means we need to do addition of this all, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 6 plus 12 divided by number of observations. How many observations are there? 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. With 6 factors are there. So divided by 6. Okay. So total is, this total will come 28. 28 divided by 6. 28 divided by 6 means what? 14 by 3. 14 by 3 means we can write 3 4s are 12 plus 2 14. So 4, 2 by 3 is the mean of all factors. Okay. So this is the arithmetic mean of all factors of 12. Okay, so now one more example you will see. Second, find the arithmetic mean of all odd numbers between 90 to 100, between 90 to and 100. Okay, in between 90 and 100, how many numbers are coming, that we need to see first. So after 90, 91, then 93, 95, 97 and 99. How many numbers are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So arithmetic mean is equal to summation of xi divided by n. Okay, is equal to, we need to do addition of this 91 plus 93 plus 95 plus 97 plus 99 divided by 5. Okay, total observations are 5. So sum is coming here 475 divided by 5. So that is 475 is 5, 9 sir 45 and 5 sir 25. Okay, so 95 is the arithmetic mean of this data. Okay, so this is, we have seen mean. Now one more example we will see here, that is the mean of, next example is the mean of 50 observations was 250. 50 was observations was 250. It was detected on checking that the value of that the value value of 165 was wrongly 165 was wrongly copied as 150. Okay, for computation of mean, find the correct mean. Okay, we need to find out here correct mean. See here, the mean of 50 observation was 250. Mean of 50 observations was 250, means mean is equal to 250. Okay, and number of observations are 50, so n is 50. Okay, so how to find out this? What is the formula for this? Mean is equal to bar x is equal to summation of xi divided by n. Okay, so here we have this value we have, so here we can put 250 is equal to summation of xi divided by this is 50. Okay, so summation, what will come? Summation of xi is equal to 250 multiply by 50. 250 multiply by 50 will be 12,500. Okay, summation of xi is 12,500. This we have. Okay, now correct value. We need to find out correct value, because what is given? It was detected on checking that the value of 165 was wrongly copied. 150. Okay, means instead of 165, 115 was taken by mistakenly. Okay, so correct value we need to find out. That is, we need to take this from this. We need to subtract. We need to take this 165 minus 150. Okay, so 12,500 minus 115. If you will subtract, then we need to add 165, because this is actually correct number. Understood? Or the difference between these two also we can subtract from this. Understood? Anyhow, so you will get this is 12,550. Okay, so correct mean, now we are going to find out correct mean is equal to 12,550 divided by 50. Okay, so here you will get 251. Okay, 251. It was 250, but now correct mean is 251. Understood? So this way we can find out the mean of the given numbers. Okay. One more example we will see, that is, next example is the mean monthly salary of 19 members of a group is rupees 1,600. One more member whose monthly salary is rupees 2,000 has joined the group. Okay, find the mean monthly salary of 20 members of the group. Okay, so here what is given? See, the mean monthly salary of 19 members means 19 members are there. 19 members means what is this? Is n is equal to 19. Okay, and mean is given 1,600. So bar x is equal to 1,600. Okay, rupees 1,600. So what is formula of mean? Bar x is equal to summation of xi divided by n. So 1,600 is equal to 1600, this value is 1600 and n is equal to 9. So what we can do here, summation of xi is equal to bar x into n. Okay, this is not given, this is given. Okay, so here what we will get, 1600 multiplied by 90. Okay, so that is, this product will be 30,400. Okay, so sum of all observations, okay, is given, is 30,400. Okay, so what is it, total salary of 19 members, total salary of 19 members is 30,400. Okay, so rupees 30,400. Now after this, what we need to do, after this we need to see the total monthly, one more, what is given, see, whose monthly one more member whose monthly salary is rupees 20,000 has joined. Okay, so total how many members are there now? 19 plus 1, there are 20 members. Okay, 20 members, and salary is 2000, salary is 2000, so it will be added in the 30,400. So total salary will be 30,400 plus 2000 is equal to 32,400. Okay, so this is new salary. So mean of 20 members will be total monthly salary divided by 20. Okay, total monthly salary is 32,400 divided by 20. So it will be 00 will be cancelled, half of 3200, 1620, rupees 1620. So total mean of 20 members is 1620. Okay, now we are going to see properties of arithmetic mean. Okay, so there are some properties. From that, first property is, if bar x, that is mean is the, or bar x is the mean of n observations. Just now we have seen of n observations. Observations we will take x1, x2, xn, then summation of n to this is equal to 0. This is the first property. Okay. See, if bar x is the mean of n observations, then x1, x2 and xn, these are the observations, then summation of this means, what is, this is mean, this is mean bar x, and this is x1 is the observation. When you will do this subtraction, that time it is 0. Okay, so this result we will see with the help of one example. Okay, so first example I am taking here, find the sum of deviations of the variates 6, 8, 10, 16, 20, 24 from their mean. Okay, so now what is our formula? Bar x is equal to x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus x4 plus x5 and plus x6 divided by 6, because here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 observations are there. So we can do here addition, 6 plus 8 plus 10 plus 16 plus 20 plus 24 divided by 6. Okay, so 84 divided, this sum is coming 84. 84 divided by 6 is 14. 14, 6 are 84. Okay, so now this is the mean. Okay, bar x, this is the value of bar x. Okay, now according to the property, what we need to see, deviation. Okay, this reference is there in class 10th. Okay, so see carefully, sum of the deviations, what is sum of the deviation of the numbers, which numbers are given? 6, 8, 10, 16, 20 and 24. Okay, so what we will do here, and our mean is x bar x is equal to 14. Okay, so 6 minus 14 we need to do. 6 minus 14. 6 minus 14 plus 8 minus 14 plus 10 minus 14 plus 16 minus 14 plus 20 minus 14 20 minus 14 plus 24 minus 14. Okay, so 6 minus 14 is 6 minus 14 will come minus 8. Okay, 8 minus 14 plus 8 minus 14 is minus 6. Then 10 minus 14 minus 4 plus 16 minus 14 2 plus 20 minus 14 6 and plus last one 24 minus 14 10. Okay, so 8 plus 6 14 plus 4 18. This will be minus 18. 10 plus 6 16 plus 2 plus 18. So it is 0. Okay, so this is the property. Okay, which we have learned. If bar x is the mean of n observation x1 x2 xn, then summation of this is equal to 0. So this is the first property of arithmetic mean. Okay, so see carefully, and some worksheets are depend in examples are given in the worksheets. Solve those worksheets. Okay, second property is show that if each observation is increased by a, then the mean is also increased by a. Okay, if each observation is increased by a, then the mean is also increased by a. Okay, we will see this property with the help of one example. Okay, so here see the mean of 20 numbers is 9 if 3 is added to every number. What will be the new mean? Okay, so definitely here mean is going to increase. Okay, so what is given? Mean is given, that is bar x is equal to 9. How many numbers are given? 20. Okay, so bar x is equal to x1 plus x2 plus how many are there? X20. Okay, total 20 divided by n, or 20 also we can take. So here what is coming? This is getting 9. Mean is given 9. X1 plus x2 plus x20 upon n is equal to 20. Okay, so here what we will get? This x1 plus x2 plus till that x20 is equal to 9 into 2. 9 2s are 180. So this sum of all observation is 180. Okay, now new numbers, how will get? If 3 is added in each and every number, this 20, from the 20 each and every number is 3 is added. So new numbers how will get? New numbers is equal to x1 plus 3, this is the first observation, x1 plus 3 plus x2 plus 3, like that. Okay, this is first, second number. Like that you will get finally x20 plus 3. Okay, so that we are going to take the mean of new numbers is equal to this sum of this will come x1 plus 3 plus x2 plus 3 plus x20 plus 3 upon numbers are same, n is same, 20. Okay, so here what is going to come? This sum is originally what we got 180. So 180 we will take, and there are 20 numbers, and in each number 3 is added. So what will be the total addition of that new which numbers we have added? 3 is added in 20 numbers. So 23 is a 60. So here we need to add 60 divided by 20. So 180 plus 60 is equal to 240 divided by 20. So that will be 12. Okay, so new mean is 12. Okay, so that only this property says, if each observation is increased by a, then the mean is also increased by a. Understood? So the new mean is 12, and old mean was 9. So 12 minus 9 is 3. Okay, 3 is added, and here also we got 3 more than the old mean. Okay, so this was the second property. The third property is, if each observation is decreased by a, then the mean is also decreased by a. Okay, we will see one example. The mean of 15 numbers is 25. If 4 is subtracted from every number, what will be the new mean? Okay, so what is given? Mean is given. Mean of 15 numbers means bar x is given 25, n is given 15. Okay, so total are 15. So bar x is equal to, how we can write, x1 plus x2 plus x15, because total 15 numbers are there, divided by n. X is given, bar x is given 25 is equal to x1 plus x2 plus x15 divided by n is 15. Okay, so sum of all observations will come. Sum of all observations will come. x1 plus x2 plus x15 is equal to 25 multiplied by 15. 25 multiplied by 15 will be what will become 375. Okay, now we need to find out new mean. Okay, so new mean is equal to this will be decreased by 4, because here they have told us subtracted 4 subtracted from every number, x1 minus 4 plus x2 minus 4 plus x15, last one observation is 15th one, so x15 minus 4 divided by 15. Okay, so this mean we have 375. Okay, 375, and 4 is subtracted from the 15 number, so 15 multiplied by 4, 15 4s are 60. Okay, so totally 60 we will subtract, but number of observations are same, so here it will come 15. So 315 divided by 15, so here it will get 15 to the 30, 51 to 50, 21. New mean is 21. Okay, now old mean was 15, and new mean is 21. Okay, new mean is 21. Understood? So this is the second property. Okay, 25, and this is 21. New old mean was 25, and new mean is 21. So 25 minus 21, 4. Okay, which number we have subtracted? Okay, our property number 4 is, if each observation is multiplied by a non-zero number a, then the mean is also multiplied by a. Okay, so this property we will see with the help of one example. The mean of 8 numbers is 25. If each number is multiplied by 2, what will be the new mean? Okay, so let the numbers be x1, x2, okay, like x8. Total 8 numbers are there, so it will come. So mean is given, mean of 8 numbers is equal to 25. Okay, so here x1 plus x2 plus x8 is equal to what will come? This is the sum of this is equal to mean into number of observations. So it will come directly n into bar x, okay, mean into number of observations. Okay, so here you will get 25 multiplied by 8, because mean it is given, okay, mean is given and number of observations are given. So 25 8s are 200. Okay, so sum of 8 observation is 200. Okay, now each observation is multiplied by 2. So how we can write this? 2x1 plus 2x2 plus, like that, last observation is x8. So 2x8 is equal to 2 into the whatever sum of this we have, that we whole we will multiply by 2. 200 into 2. So that will be 400. Okay, so new sum of the observation is 400. Okay, so new mean is equal to this sum, new sum divided by number of observations, that is 8. So 400 divided by 8, so that is 50. Okay, so mean is 50. Old mean was 25 and 25 twos are 50, because 2 we have multiplied by 2 to each observation. Okay, so this was the fourth property. So property number 5 is, if each observation is divided by a non-zero number, then the mean is also divided by 8. Okay, so we will see one example. The mean of 68 numbers is 18. If each number is divided by 6, find a new mean. Find a relation between the new mean and the old mean. Okay, so what is given here? Mean of 68 numbers is equal to 18. Okay, so sum of 68 numbers will be, how we will get, mean is given this and number of, so 68 multiplied by 18. So 68 multiplied by 18, this is the total sum. Okay, now what is given? If each number is divided by 6, the sum is also divided by 6. Okay, so new sum will be 68 multiplied by 18. This is old sum. Okay, 68 multiplied by 18, and now it will be divided by 6. So 6 threes are 18. So 68 multiplied by this is the new sum, 68 multiplied by 3. Okay, now what we need to find out? New mean is equal to, how we will get new mean? 68 divided by 68, because total numbers are 68, understood? So new sum is 68 multiplied by 3 divided by 68. Okay, so that you will get 68 will be cancelled, so 3. Okay, so new mean is equal to, they are asking one more question. They have asked us, find the relation between the new mean and the old mean. So new mean, what is new mean? 3. How will you get 3? That is old mean, original mean or old mean divided by 6. Okay, original mean, what was original mean? 18 divided by 6 is equal to 3. So this is the relation. So we have seen 5 properties of arithmetic mean. Okay, so solve the worksheet which is given and which is depend on this. Also solve the problems from the NCERT textbook. Thank you.